There are three main data entry apps that are used when entering event and tracker data. This includes the Capture app, which is used for event data, and Tracker Capture, which is used for tracker data. Both of these apps are the web versions of the app that you would use on a computer. There is also the Android Capture app, which allows you to collect aggregate, event, and tracker data all within the same app on an Android device. The Capture app is a new app launched in version 2.31 to allow for easier data entry of event programs. Previously, data were entered into the Event Capture app. This app is still available, but will be phased out over time. In this course, we will only be using the Capture app to demonstrate event data entry as it has the newest features. However, it may be the case that you are working on a version of DHIS2 where the Capture app is not available, or it is available and you are still using the Event Capture app. If this is the case, or you are just interested in learning more about the Event Capture app, there are materials in the download section of this module where you can get more information. The Capture app has an enhanced interface which has larger text, more room on the screen to view items, allows for seamless entry of multiple events, and has a new row view where the data elements in the form can be viewed horizontally rather than the original form view where the data elements are listed vertically. The Tracker Capture app is the app used for entering data on tracker programs. An entity must always be registered when using a tracker program, so it can be tracked, as the name implies, over services and time. Registration and searching for entities is therefore a key component of the Tracker Capture app. The Android Capture app is available on Android devices and allows for data entry of all data types. This allows for people in the field with no internet connectivity to enter data through the app offline. Unfortunately, there is no support for Apple devices at this stage. We will be covering the Android app in much more detail in the Data Capture module. Switching to the analytics side of the system, there are a number of different ways to view event and tracker program data. The two new apps you will be familiarizing yourself with in this course are the Event Reports and the Event Visualizer apps. The Event Reports app allows you to create pivot tables or line lists based on event or tracker data. The pivot tables give you an aggregated number of events, and the line lists allow you to make searches or queries for events based on a set of criteria that you specify. We also have the Event Visualizer app. This app is very similar to the Data Visualizer app, but allows you to view event and tracker program data. We will cover the Event Reports and Event Visualizer applications in a lot more detail in the Data Analysis module. Now, I'm sure you are already thinking about all of the benefits of using the event and tracker programs, but let's highlight some major ones. We are easily able to aggregate individual case data to import into facility-based aggregated HMIS systems, which allows for a more streamlined data collection process, avoiding double data entry. We can review individual data and create line lists as needed based on the data that we have collected. We can track needs assessments in communities, villages, facilities, etc. And we can also better plan for activities for field workers based on these assessments. we can capture data at a much more granular level than would be possible in the aggregate model. Rather than having to finalize predefined disaggregations and combinations before the data are collected, this can all be done after. There will be an improvement in data quality and data quality practices as the amount of manual aggregation can significantly be reduced. Additionally, you will have source data that you can refer back to in the event a data quality issue is identified. We hope this has given you a good overview of what the event and tracker models can be used for. We will go over a lot of these concepts again in much more detail as we move through the course. In the next session, we are going to discuss the term use case and explain why they are so often used to help us define DHIS2 configurations.